DJs.
Oh, it's feeling real soulful in here now. What's up, everybody? You are live once again with the DJs that like to spin it, mix it, play it back, and dissect it. It is the Dissect DJs. Representing the crew, I am DJ Castle, and we got another throwback episode for y'all. And we are throwing this one way back. In fact, I believe it's actually as far back as we can throw it because it is all the way back to episode 2. Of the Three Things We Gotta Talk About podcast, which was actually the very first time that I was ever joined with DJ Jag, Mr. Justino Garcia himself. It was actually the first time we ever did any kind of podcast recording together. And in case you're not aware, Three Things We Gotta Talk About is my original podcast in which we discuss three unique topics each episode, which is coming back for another season real soon. There are several classic films in which I intend to break down three things style, so keep an ear out for that one. But for thing three, we introduce a new segment that was called Break Down This Song. Break down this song. And we kick that off with a breakdown of this legendary R&B track right here, the one and only Boyz II Men's 1991 classic, End of the Road. And I'm just going to say right off the top, I did not realize this song went all the way back to 91. Felt like maybe more of a 93, 94 classic to me, but I just looked it up, and the internet is never wrong about anything. So anyways, this was thing number three from episode 2 of Three Things We Gotta Talk About, and really hatched the original embryonic idea that eventually would become the Dissect DJs, which of course is this awesome podcast that you are listening to now. So you could say if it wasn't for this original episode of Three Things, maybe we wouldn't be sitting here today. And maybe you wouldn't be sitting there right now. Just kidding, I don't think anything we do on this podcast affects any way that you live life, but to add a little bit of excitement and fun to your day. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump right into our dissection of Boyz II Men's End of the Road. And just a little quick programming note, at the end of the episode, because this was still directly from the Three Things We Gotta Talk About podcast, I just go ahead and let the final minutes of that episode play out as it was, so there is no slaps and snaps given because there was no format at the time that we originally recorded this. But maybe when me and Justino get back into the studio, we'll do a little aftermath snaps and slaps of this absolute gem of an R&B track from the early 90s. And then we intend to be back next week with some brand new records, so get hyped for that. But in the meantime, let's go ahead and find out what happens when you reach the end of the road.
Girl, you know we belong together. I don't have no time for you to be playing with my heart like this. You'll be mine forever, baby. You just need me.
We belong.
Can we pause it real quick? All right. I want to make a quick prediction before we even play the song any further. So obviously this is Boyz II Men, End of the Road, which anybody that grew up in the 90s is a cornerstone of our upbringing. Yeah. I have a quick prediction.
I must have listened to the CD of Boyz II Men like more than
we all had
CD
that CD.
Growing up.
We all did. And
with the big two.
There's that big two and the two, but not like a number two. It was like the
Roman numeral two,
yeah. Right. I have a prediction that by the end of this song, me and you are both just going to start belting out notes as hard as we can.
Yeah.
Because I know this man, and that's where this ends up every single time. So I want to apologize in advance and not deter anybody from listening further, because we're going to break down. We should explain actually what the segment is. I think it's pretty self-explanatory. Okay. Basically, we're going to break down a classic song. And
listen to the lyrics.
We're gonna kind of get inside their head.
Find out what they were speaking
of. What exactly did they mean by end of the road? And we're just talking over each other, but you know, I think the gist was got. All right, go ahead and hit it back up.
Why do you
That's a fair question.
Fair question. What, yeah. Ladies, why do you play with our hearts
and
our minds? Is it because we play with your minds and your hearts? Is it because you initially play with our hearts and our minds?
Some of them get their rocks
off. And is it because you
that.
Initially got your... I've lost my mind.
Yeah. No, it's... I mean, it's a fair question to ask. And I think we've all been at that moment at some point where we're just kind of like staring up at the sky and we're wondering this as it goes. But when it's another man singing it, it's easy to just be like, you being a bitch.
Bitch.
Sing it up.
Said we'd be forever. Sitting there the
time. Okay, first of all, if my girlfriend comes up to me and she says, this is never going to die, I'll be like,
I mean, it's...
Are you okay? Let's take... Why are you... You could have said that in so many different ways. It's never gonna die?
Yeah.
Do you need... Are you okay? Do you want to... Are you hungry? You're hungry. You're hangry, aren't you? And then you said it'd be forever? This girl's psycho. How long were you dating her before she said that?
Isn't he the one who's saying
no.
it right now?
She said that.
I do want to know in the terms said of the song, how long is this relationship that we're discussing?
Oh, he might have said it, huh? I thought she said it. He might be saying that. He might be too aggressive.
Yeah, no, well, I think that's what we're going to learn as the song goes. It's like, you're a bit much, dude.
He's too much. That's why.
Yeah, that's the early indication here. But go ahead, let it roll.
How could you love me and leave me and never say goodbye?
Of course she's not going to say goodbye. You think she's going to bone you and then bone somebody else and be like, oh, by the way, bye.
I don't know. Like, she's if my homie came goodbye. Up to me with this, like, and he started with this, I'd be like, sounds like you're fucking with a hoe, but,
I mean, what's her number?
Why are you crying, dude?
Stop crying, dude. Man. What's the deal?
Like, I don't know.
So you
like,
break down and cry.
Break down. That's an aggressive cry right there. And you're telling all your homies. The way I hear this song is he's kind of like, do you hear it as he's like talking to his homies or is he just, let's actually put it in perspective of how he's putting this out there in the ether. Is he talking to the girl holding up a boombox, like say anything? Is that what you were seeing right here? Or is he like kind of talking to the other boys, two men?
I feel like he's talking to her.
Via song.
Yeah.
Through the majesty of song.
That's when I can't sleep at night.
Without holding you tight.
Girl, each time I try, he just breaks down and cries. This man is not sleeping.
That is a bad way
dude,
to be.
Come on.
You're tripping,
dude. All There's right. no way it was that good, bro.
Imagine if your friend told, like, your homie told you that's how he's spending his life. It's like, you'd be like, I don't even know exactly where to go with that, bro. Talk to a therapist, I think. That's probably where this needs to
go.
Be
crying,
bro. Yeah. Don't break down and cry. Stop it. Bro, you'd rather be dead?
Dead?
That's aggressive. That's, dude, now we got suicide watch. Definitely talk to a therapist, bro. Like, that's a bit
one of my favorite parts coming up right here. Spinning around. I've loved that since I was a kid.
Yeah.
He could have said spinning.
I do love.
And around. No,
he said.
Spinning.
You actually musically the ability to stretch a single word and actually make it sound good, very difficult. So a story aside, hey, props on the musical adventure right there. I actually never.
When I was a kid, I've always loved
that. To be honest, I never even noticed it worked that way until you just pointed it out to me. So that was a good call. Good
yeah, man. Spin. Yeah, anyways. All right, we were talking about it. Here we go.
So you know it's the end of the road, though.
I can't let you go. It's unnatural. Woo! You belong to me.
That's understandable. It's the end of the road. You can't let go.
All right, but let me just say this about that. He's admitting it's the end of the road. It kind of goes against the ethos of this entire song. Like, his whole thing is, I'm not ready for this to be done. I'm still into this.
But he knows.
But he's saying it's the end of the road.
Although we've gone.
He's acknowledging that this is the end of the road. So, like,
There you go, though. You know ultimately where this lies. So then why are you crying about it, dude? Why are you crying to her about it? I don't know. Maybe that's just me being an insensitive prick.
No, I'm with you. Yeah. I'm with you. All right, second verse. Girl, I know you really love me.
You just don't realize. I don't know. That's a stretch, bro. You know she loves you. She just doesn't realize it.
You really try to prove it to yourself, sir.
Yeah, you know what? I think at a certain point, you kind of got to look in the mirror on this one, bro. Like,
you are continuously
more. You know she loves you. She just doesn't realize it. Like, that's some mental gymnastics right there.
The more I listen to this song, I've loved this song since I was a kid.
We all have.
The more you sound like a biatch.
Yeah, it's hard to get around. You've never been there before. It's only
your first time. Wait, you're saying because you took her virginity,
is that
she's supposed to love you?
And by the way, I don't buy that. I don't really think that this is her first time, but you know, hey, what? Again, I feel like more mental gymnastics. You're trying to spin a web, bro. Yeah, I'm not really.
Let her go.
Yeah,
let her go.
I think it'd be best for all.
The end of the road has come.
Yeah, just, you know it. You were singing the song.
Make a U-turn.
It's coming to the end of the road. Maybe I'll give
you. Wait, you have to forgive her.
Why are you forgiving her?
But, dude, you're
okay. Wait,
you're tripping.
Let's hear it. Let me hear. Like, what you do? Maybe you'll try. She's not, dude.
She's not trying.
No, she's over it. We shouldn't be happy together
forever. You and I. Yeah, but you're not.
Okay, and this is like the best part of the song coming up right here. You might actually know the words here, but I feel like the best thing about this next part is I have no idea what he's saying, but every note is spot on.
Actually, I don't know what he said right there.
I don't know at all, but I love it. He's getting after it right there, and I appreciate it. That's when he starts to win me back a little bit. Oh, that is that part. I will say this, and I know you will agree with me on this. That is the single best backup singer moment in the history of R&B right there. Yeah, like they just, yeah, absolutely. He doesn't, again, he doesn't even need to really be saying clear
don't
words.
Don't at us.
Don't at me. Don't at me, bro.
Whatever, fuck that.
You know what it is. Help me out a little bit.
Alright, here we go. Now we're gonna discuss this.
Alright, go ahead and pause it. Now this is ultimately,
since I was a kid.
Yeah. This is the main part that we wanted to break down right here.
This is why we got picked this song,
man. This is where the whole situation falls off the axle. Go ahead.
Let's like preempt this, dude. You've all heard this. If you haven't heard this, you're going to hear it. He talks deeply.
So you're dealing with a situation. Obviously, this is the end of a relationship. That much has been
established. You already know it's the end of the road, and this happens?
He said something about needing to forgive. We haven't touched on that until this point. And this, by the way, I will say this. We don't get enough deep voice breakdowns in R&B music these days. That I do miss.
But also,
you don't
crazy
get
breakdowns like this that go this route. Here we go. We're going to let the whole thing play.
Yeah.
And then we're stopping at the end and discuss the entire
thing.
We need
to discuss this for sure. Girl, I'm here for you. All those times at night when you just heard me and just ran out with that other fella. Baby, I knew about it. I just didn't care. You just don't understand how much I love you, do you? I'm here for you. Again. Let's just go ahead and break this down in perspective of, like, this is your homie coming to you talking about his relationship problems. What
man would, in his right mind, listen to his friend and I'm like, are you telling me your girl's straight been running around in front of your face and you're straight gonna look her in the eye and be like, babe, I knew about that. I just didn't care.
The exact words are, girl, I'm here for you. All those times of night when you just hurt me and you just ran out with that other fella, baby, I knew about it. I just didn't care.
I'm gonna call bullshit.
You just don't understand how much I love you, dude.
This is the...
I'm here for you.
What? This is the essential desperation plea right here. Because you're gonna tell her that in your desperation mode. Like, no, man. I know you got that shit going. But, like, I don't care, man.
It's no, you fucking him, but No. Baby.
If this whole strategy works and she comes back, you're changing your tune on that one. I'm gonna say it.
Like, there's no chance.
You're not gonna maintain that whole...
You might be drunk,
like,
just saying
yeah.
this.
Yeah. No. This is just throwing whatever you can at the wall.
Oh, you're trying
to. You're
just yeah. lost. Yeah.
But if it actually works, there's no way you're gonna maintain this whole I don't care.
Do
no.
that one more
oh, wait. You going out with Tyrone tonight? Baby, that's cool. I don't care.
Right, have fun. Have fun. I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah. Just come back to me.
I got a foot massage when you get here, baby. Get out of here.
All those times at night when you just hurt me and just ran out with that other fella. Baby, I knew about it. I just didn't care. You just don't understand how much I love you, do you? I'm here for you. I'm not out to go out there and cheat all night, just like you did, baby, but that's alright.
That was a subtle dig right there. Did you hear that?
He just subtle
dig. That was a little dig. This is making me sad, and wait, not because of his pain. It's because he's talking about his dying day. He's talking about how he'd rather be dead. He's talking about how he's running around in front of her and he
and
don't care.
She's fucking Tyrone.
There's plenty of other songs made in this era about women like this, and it definitely has a different tone. Boyz, this is before they became two men, I gotta say. This
Would
is
you
the
say
Boyz.
He truly love this woman, or he just infatuated her? What is it? What does he have?
If you want me to Dr. Drew this shit.
Yeah, real quick.
Yeah. Okay, so there's definitely an element of infatuation. Basically, if I had to break it down in layman's terms, she got some bomb pussy.
I love you anyway. And I'm still gonna be here for you till my dying day, baby. Right now, I'm just in so much pain, baby, because you just won't come back to me. Will you? Just come back to me. Yes, baby, my heart is lonely. My heart hurts, baby. Yes, I feel pain too.
It doesn't make sense. Cause I don't even know who's the one. You can't see the lighter right now, but it's okay.
Three topics talked about.
I would like to say that there's absolutely no way that song can be listened to where it doesn't turn into everybody in the room just breaking it down. That's the way it's gone every single time I've been in a room where End of the Road plays. Like, we could talk shit about him throughout the entire song because this fool's being a bitch.
He's being a bitch.
He's talking about killing
he's
himself.
He's killing himself.
He would rather die than let him run around with Tyrone.
He knows she's cheating on
he
him.
He knows it. He calls
he's
it out.
He's okay with it.
He's saying he doesn't care.
But you know what, ladies and gentlemen? You will sing
that is a
that
jam.
Song at the top
ultimately,
of your
he ends up winning you over. Yeah, like, if she doesn't come back after you sing that, she ain't worth it, bro. There's no way.
We've reached the end of the road.
And on that note, I think we have reached the end of the road of this podcast.
That's
that
what
is,
I'm talking about.
That is 3.5 things that we've talked about.
So I can one-up him. You guys only talked about three things, you and Juan, but we talked about three and a half. So, got your ass, Juanie. Got your ass, homie.
That is the three things you got to talk about podcast. Yep. Come back every Wednesday.
Every single, well.
Or Thursday. I don't know. We're going to figure out
the every week, though. That's every for week. Sure. I'll be here once a month. I look forward to talking to all you guys next month. Whatever month that is, we're going to talk about three other topics. And me and Cass are going to be
going to come back with three more bangers to discuss. Justin Sun, thank you so much for being a part of this podcast.
Love you, man. You're my dog for life.
You're my dog for life. Ever since I knocked you out in Fight Night.
You didn't knock me out, but
it was good.
You beat me, though.
Yeah, man. Hammered your face pretty good, though.
Yeah?
I literally said it because I wanted to see you call me back on that, but yeah.
No. Yeah, you didn't
knock me out. Yeah, that was a good fight, though. So until next time, we are out of here.
Yeah.